Ahi ahi pai. Kia ora, my name is Nain. I call myself the Joy Ninja because I am trying to create abundance on a teeny tiny income. Welcome to my regular cash stuffing video. So let's do this. There's no surprises here. My food is going to get its regular 170. Petrol is getting 50. And fun, which is takeaways, but it's also little bits and pieces I buy for the kids after school. That's getting 30. So I hope you had a lovely Waitangi day. I didn't do much at all, but check this out. This is starting for me today with a webinar, but for the next 8 weeks I'm going to do a Thrive to 5k program with my local doctors. So yeah, that's going to be full on. I'll let you know how I go. I'm a little bit timid about it. You'll notice as well that this week, I am going to be, just let me reach in my wallet. I'm just going to swap that 10 out for those two fives. That's mum money, by the way. I don't budget that, but mum gives me a bit of cash to have in my wallet for her needs. So if she needs anything, she can text me. And I can go and grab it from the supermarket for her. The reason I did that is because my big girl gets $15, so we just stick that out of the way. That's her allowance. Anyway, as I was saying, it is going to be a busy month, I think. So $40 in pin money. And the reason I'm not spending this is because I am doing Liz and Lisa's Leap Ahead and Save Challenge. I looked at, this is a freebie. You can go and get it from, I hope I'm doing this right. I need more practice at this, ugh, yikes. From, that's her channel logo thing. So just look up Liz or Liz. And while we're up here, there's like three ways you can play this game. I'm doing the El Cheapo way because I was on a limited income, so 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35. We'll just shove that in there. There is $40 in pin money. At the end of the month, I'll have a little bit of extra money to probably put in my hobbies, a part of the binder. You'll see that in a minute. Household is going to get 20 as well. And I am hitting these envelopes quite hard and will be over the next wee while because, like D, another cash stuffer NZ, it's not my income that's going to change. That goes up and down. It's just hard. It's more a case of I'm going to be, the rent's going to go up by 50 bucks a week, which is quite a lot. So anyway, beauty has got 20, 40, 60, 70, 80, 90, 100. And I need 180 in there by the end of February. Wellbeing has 40. I'm going to give it 60, but I do need to go and pick up vitamins for the kids. So expect that to be a little bit lower the next time I see you. Clothes is also going to get 20. There's no immediate need for clothing items. There's a bit of uniform I'm trying to pick up secondhand. I don't know whether I'll take it out of this budget, clothing or education, which is, yeah, is there for uniforms. But also, I don't know, autumn tends to be the time when we just double check all the coats fit and stuff like that. Gumboots. There's 10 in hobbies. I'm going to give it that 5. So now it has 15. And Family Fun has got 20. Gifts has got 20, I believe. This is just gifts for people outside of my immediate family. I save for them separate. And then Giving is just for charity stuff. Oh, and speaking of charity stuff, I've also signed up to volunteer. So 15 there for a local charity, just once a week. And I'm waiting for them to get back to me and let me know what the go is there. Miscellaneous has just got 5 on it. Adventure, nothing at the moment. I do have one of my goals for this first 3 months of the year is to save $250 in that adventure fund. I might not make that. It's not a top priority. I'd rather focus on getting that emergency fund sorted. Anyway, in the sinking funds binder, I'm going to hit education today. Each of these is 25. But that last one I just filled with 20, so I just wrote 20 in there. So if I do that and go 15 there, then the tracker should match what I've got. So I've got 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, and I have $70 online. Oh, look. Just have to take my word for it. There is some money on the online account. And I need to be contributing to this weekly because I pay for their school fees sort of broken up throughout the year. Vision Fund isn't going to get anything, but I will give Health 20. That leaves us with 10. 20, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, 100 in health. Now each of these is 5. I'm not going to colour the last two ones actually. I will. What will I do? I'll put $10 straight into my wallet, and that's because I have to go and pay for a health appointment. So now that my big girl is 15, she's actually been charged for health visits, which I don't know. That wasn't on my radar. I wasn't thinking about that. But yeah, she is being charged, so I owe them some money, and I'll go and clear that bill today. Dental, that's happening at the end of the week. So yeah, I'm starting a Thrive to 5K. I'm having dental surgery. And I've got an assignment due next Tuesday, so she's a bit full. Right, what else was I going to do? Oh, car. Sorry, I'm just looking for to see if I've got any other $5 notes kicking around, actually. Yes, I will be recording a Sunday savings video this Sunday, so stay tuned for that. I figured if I put 5 on here, see, I've got 125 in the bank, and I've got 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70. So if I put the 5 in, with that 25, that makes 200 all up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3. And in preparation for this change in rent, I need to sit down and do my budget. But before I did that, I rang around. I managed to get my cost down on my car insurance. And I just did that through raising the excess. So the excess was $400, it's now $1,000, which, you know, has flow-on implications. But the reason I can do that is because I have money in my month ahead in my emergency fund. And, you know, they are there not specifically for car, in an ideal world, I would have $1,000 for car. But as it stands, if I needed to make a claim tomorrow, I do have cash I can access for that excess. So I felt safe enough to raise the excess from 400 to 1,000. Does that make sense? Anyway, makes sense in my brain. And it meant I save, I think, about $6 or $7 a month on the insurance, which is very, very helpful. All those little bits and pieces seem insignificant, but they do, you know, they do add up. I think I'm going to put $5 onto Easter. So Easter now has 25, so I'm halfway to my goal of $50, and I'm hoping to not even spend that much. If I manage to have anything left over in notes from Easter, like, you know, $1, $2, I'm not going to worry, but anything sort of $5 or more, I'm just going to put that into the next, well, Christmas, actually. I'm going to put that towards Christmas. Thinking on my feet there. Alright, so that's all for in that binder. My long-term savings binder, this one. Now, I know I committed to doing these two here. So that's $12 out of my change I'm going to put in there. And then the rest of my change is going to go into Pearl. So let's give her a wee count. That's $2.80 today. Right, that is there. Oh, if you want this, this comes in my savings challenge booklet, which of course I've got none to hand. But yeah, I made a little booklet. It's on Buy Me a Coffee, and this is one of the challenges. I think there's like 18 challenges in the entire book, and there's some extra bits and pieces. So that's there. Also, someone was asking about when I'm going to restart my shop. So I just am putting things on Buy Me Coffee at the moment. I just don't have the bandwidth for Etsy, and it's a lot of work for them taking a whole lot of fees. So my plan is to slowly transition some of the Buy Me a Coffee, slowly transition some of the things that I was selling, because I do have pre-made stuff, over. And it's just a matter of putting that on slowly. So if there was anything in particular that you were keeping an eye out or you wanted, please leave me a comment below and I can throw that up on Buy Me a Coffee. Otherwise, it's just going to happen slowly. But as I said, I've got a little bit on at the moment. So look, I hope you're having a wonderful week. And if you haven't entered the competition, go back to last Wednesday's video. I give you all the details. That competition is open and running until Saturday. I'm really excited, but I'm also quite nervous because I haven't run a competition on this scale, but I think I know what I'm about, so, you know, fingers crossed it all goes well with the drawing and so on and so forth. I will do my best, that's what I can promise you. All right, have a great week. Kia ora.